When we dealt with the first wave, it was new for all of us. There was a lot of panic. It's needless to say that we were trying to figure out resources. That's how from the ration drive we came to the bed resources. We realized that there was a real-time gap that was needed to be filled when people were out there and not feeling well in the ambulances. There were hours, like 4 to 5 hours, when they would stand outside the hospitals, not knowing when they would get the bed. That is how SOS Saviors was born in the first place. I and Dial 4242 ambulance service, the co-owner of that, G2, is a friend, and we both started this together in the very initial phase. And slowly we added a lot of other change makers, as I call them, to join the league. And we realized we needed help with medicines, real-time update on hospitals, where do we find the beds. If you ask me the stark difference, Anisha, here, there's one thing that we thought second wave will be extremely prepared because of what happened in the first wave. But second wave in itself was not less of any other panic. And there were days when, like Chaiti said, since we are all on Twitter, we would have interacted once with each other, some case or the other. And it was a panic situation. We were talking about cylinders going down, trying to talk to agencies, getting refills done, helping the hospitals. The narratives really, changed from whose responsibility to our responsibility. We realized that the public government partnership that was needed, NGO stepping up, and volunteer initiative like ours coming forward and saying, let's do this together. And very little pinpointing happened at that time, more of solution-driven initiatives like Jyoti mentioned, including people like Tehsin or all of our volunteers who are there in various areas. We have Dr. Yogita in Pune. We had teams of KWF, like Kidney Warrior Foundation works for dialysis patient. I'm a part of that family. And I realized the dialysis patient had no clue if they were COVID positive. They had reservations. They didn't know where to go. They didn't know what is the availability. Some of them couldn't afford private hospitals. So what were the reservations in government hospitals or the COVID care centers? All of this information gathering is something that we invested ourselves in.